In this video, you will learn which regulatory compliance question on governance and management information can help you self-assess your firm's financial crime systems and controls. So let's get right into today's video. Hi and welcome to FinCrime Agent. This is my YouTube channel where I'm talking about financial crime prevention and anti-money laundering related topics. This video is part of a short tutorial series that I have created on regulatory compliance with insights from the FCA handbook. The aim of these tutorials is to support professionals working in the financial crime prevention with the assessment of key areas within systems and controls. Today I'm covering governance and management information, so let's bring up some slides to discover what kind of questions can help you assess if your firm is in line with regulatory compliance requirements. Governance. Senior management is expected to be fully engaged with the management of financial crime risks, and clear responsibilities must be taken. Some questions to self-assess if your firm is in line with the regulatory compliance requirements on financial crime governance could be: when was the last time that senior management considered financial crime risks and what actions were taken? How is senior management kept updated about financial crime risks? What kind of evidence are retained by the firm about escalations to senior management? Management information and reporting. Financial crime-related MI must be produced to keep under control the firm's risk exposure to financial crime and comply with the regulatory reporting requirements. MI reporting must be regularly shared with senior management and with risk forums to ensure financial crime risks are within the firm risk appetite. The regular circulation of MI should also ensure that the right level of escalations are considered when risks are identified. Some examples of financial crime MI to meet regulatory compliance reporting requirements could be: overview of the financial crime risks, including any emerging risks; rating the effectiveness of the systems and controls in place related to financial crime; business relationships risks, for example, high-risk accounts, exited customers due to financial crime, transaction monitoring and sanction screening figures, and volumes of suspicious activity reports. And this is the end of my regulatory compliance video on governance and management information. If this tutorial was useful to you, support my channel by subscribing to FinCrime Agent. In the description of the video, you will find the other links for the free parts also recorded on regulatory compliance systems and controls. So that's all for today. I hope you have enjoyed and thank you for watching. Until next time, see you soon.